Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session, and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.
Hello, everybody. I hope everyone is doing great, right? Okay. I hope everybody went through the submission instructions at the beginning of the class. Don't worry if you haven't. We'll play it again at the end of the class and you can have a look there and you can make your submissions accordingly. Okay. So everybody excited for today's class? Any guesses what today's class is going to be about? Okay, so in today's class, we are going to learn about resist painting. What is resist painting? It combines two mediums of art in which one medium resists the other. So for today's class, we are going to use wax crayons and watercolors. Okay, so what happens is that wax is water resistant and your watercolors use water as a medium, right? So when you paint on top of wax using watercolors, you will see that the color will not fall on the part where the wax covers the paper surface. So you will get a resistance on that part. Hence the name resist painting. Okay. So everybody ready with all of the materials for today's class? It's going to be an interesting technique that you can use in making all of your stuff like greetings cards, your projects. Okay. All right, so let's quickly get started and see what are all of the materials that you need for today's class. Okay, so is everybody able to see my screen? All right, so you can see I will be drawing within that box that I have just made. Don't worry, that is just for your reference so that you know how much of the area to cover. All right, you can take up your full paper space and you can draw accordingly. Okay, so let us first go through what are all the materials that we need for today's class. So here you have your paper, all right, the paper on which you'll be making your painting. Apart from that, what else do you need? Let's just quickly see. Everybody can just check. Okay, we'll need the paper. We'll need our brushes for the watercolor part. Okay, and what else we need our watercolors. Even poster colors are fine, okay? Remember to use lots of water if you are using poster colors. Apart from that, you will need your wax crayons or oil pastels, simple Camlin, Faber-Castell, any brand that you have yourself, okay? That is fine. What else do you need? You will also need a glass of water or a jar of water, which you will be using for your watercolor purpose. Okay, everybody quickly get ready with all of the materials. And everybody, you can just choose your favorite color, which you will be using. Now, when you choose your color, remember it should be a nice and bright color. Okay, like see here, I've got lime yellow with myself. I will be using lime yellow. Okay, so choose a nice bright color. You can choose orange, you can choose red, you can choose blue. Okay, but it should be nice and bright and a happy color. So everybody get started and just select a color for yourself. You can also go with white. Okay, even white is fine. Everybody quickly get ready with your paper and your crayon, whichever crayon you want to use. Just avoid using colors like black, dark blue, purple, okay, the ones that are dark. Avoid using them. We'll quickly get started with it. Everybody ready? Okay, so we'll draw a pattern of leaves on this paper, okay, using nothing but just the crayons. Everybody knows how leaves are, right? They start off tapered from one end, wide in the between, and then again it tapers onto the other end. So that is the shape we are looking for. So just fill this entire paper with leaves, okay? Just see, I will be showing you. So here I have my crayon. I will be using it to make the leaves. Okay. See the shape of the leaves. Nicely cover your paper surface. Okay. It shouldn't be uneven. Nicely cover it up with the crayon and draw the borders. Don't use a pencil. Avoid using a pencil to draw because then your wax marks will not be properly visible. Directly draw with your crayons. It's a very, very simple shape. Everybody knows how to make leaves, right? Just fill your paper with leaves like this. Make nice large leaves, okay? And make the borders nice and thick. Yes, very good. Just cover all of the surface with leaves like this. Everybody knows how to make leaves, right? It's better if you use a nice bright color like yellow or white or pink or even orange. Okay? Just cover it all up with leaves. Make the sides of the leaves nice and thick. Don't make very thin borders. Okay, you can make some overlapping leaves also like this one that I've just made. You can see it looks as if one leaf is on top of the other. So just fill the entire portion in which you're going to draw with leaves like this. If you have a larger sheet of paper, if you have an A4 or a drawing copy, make large leaves, okay? Otherwise, you'll take up a lot of time to fill it up with the leaves. If you have a larger sheet of paper like me, you can either draw large leaves or you can draw in a section of the paper like I am doing. See, my paper is large, hence I have taken a small section of the paper in which I'm going to make my painting. We'll just wait for everybody. Meanwhile, I'll be filling up the entire area with leaves. Okay? Just get the basic idea how to do this, how to make this particular resist painting. Don't worry if you've just joined or if you're a little behind. Don't worry, you can just grasp the basic idea, and then using that, you can make your real painting and you can make the submission accordingly. All right? There's nothing to worry. You are just here to learn. Okay, so you can see I filled up the entire area with the leaf shapes. Okay? You can leave it at this if you want. You can simply leave it at this. Or else we can go ahead and make the veins of the leaves. Okay, we can make some little designs on the leaves so that they look more lifelike, and your final picture will turn out to be prettier. So just see, if you've drawn at least one leaf, just see how you will make the veins. Just join the two ends of the leaves by a straight or a little bit of wavy line. Like this. Join all of the leaves like this. It's very simple, right? Every one of us have drawn a leaf before. So we all know how to make the leaves. Very, very simple. Everybody just finish this step. We'll wait for everyone to complete this. Everybody join all the leaf ends using a straight, slightly wavy line. Okay? Why is it not completely straight? Because we don't want it to look as if it's a drawing. We want it to be as real as possible. Hence, we are making the line a little curvy. Okay? Yeah. Everybody quickly complete this before we move on to the next step of detailing. Everyone, quickly complete this step. You just have to draw a line starting from one end of the leaf to the other. And for the leaves that are half, that are not fully visible, just leave it at the center. Just end the line at the center of the leaves. You can see for the leaves that are at the corners, how we've made the line. We just left it in the center. Okay, next, everybody knows how to make the veins of the leaves. Just see. We'll just see one example here. Just make V's like this. It's almost like a V. Okay, and the center of the V is along the straight line that you've just drawn. So just draw veins like this for all of the leaves. Everybody knows this, right? We've all seen a leaf before. We've all drawn it before. So it should be very easy. All right, just finish drawing these veins for all of the leaves that you've made. Okay, so that completes the wax crayon portion. Okay, that is the point till which we are going to use your wax crayons. After this, it's the work with watercolors. So everybody quickly complete the crayon portion. Okay, everyone quickly complete the detailing on the leaves like this with the help of your crayon. If you want to be a little adventurous, what you can do is in your further projects, whenever you use this technique, you can make the leaves using one color and the veins of the leaves, you can use another color that is bright. Okay, like you can make your leaves, the outline you can make orange and the veins you can make yellow. Okay, completely up to you. But remember, don't use dark colors. Don't use dark color crayons when you are doing resist painting. Otherwise, the effect will not be properly visible and you won't feel as if it's giving a glow effect at the end of your painting. Okay, so always remember to use a nice, bright and light color. Quickly complete the detailings, everyone. Those of you who have completed, get ready with a nice thick brush, okay, and your jar of water and pour out some nice happy colors. Happy colors, I mean orange, blue, pink, green, okay? All of these colors are the happy colors. So just pour out some of these happy colors and take a nice jar of water and your thickest brush and get ready. Rest of you first complete the crayon portion and then we can move on to the watercolors. Quickly complete this, everyone. We'll just wait up for everybody before we move on to the next step. All right, is everybody done with it? So see now for the next step, I have poured out the colors on my palette. Okay, you can use a normal plate like mine. And here's my jar of water that I will be using for the watercolor portion. Okay, so see here, I have my palette. Okay, and it has all the colors. I've taken three colors, your blue and you can see the thick brush that I'm going to be using. So I've taken blue, scarlet red. You can use pink if you don't have scarlet red, or you can use any other color, any other of the happy colors that I mentioned, and green. Okay, at least three colors because we want it to look nice and colorful. Okay, and remember when you're coloring on top of the wax, remember to use lots of water. Mix the colors first with lots of water and only then you can use your brush on the paper, okay? If you have a thin paper, if you have a very thin paper, just be a little careful. Don't rub the surface with the brush a lot. Be smooth, be gentle with your paper so that it doesn't tear off, okay? So we'll start off. Just see here. See, I have added so much water. It's nice and runny, okay? The color you can see, it's nice and runny. That should be the consistency of your color. Okay, and we'll start off from the side. Just see, can you see the magic? The color is not falling on the parts where we have covered with the crayon. All other parts are getting covered, but the places where we've used the crayon, the color is not falling. Keep changing your colors and keep painting. See, I was painting with blue. Now I've switched to green. So this is the idea. Okay. Keep changing the colors and keep painting. See again, can you see the magic? The color is not falling on the parts where we have used the crayons. Again, switch it up a little bit. Use a little bit of red. Color the center part. See, it's almost a pinkish purplish red, that is a scarlet red. So in this way, just keep changing the colors one by one. See, this is a very thick color. If I use it, what happens? See, it is covering up. We don't want that. So take a little bit of water and just thin up the color. And now see how you can see the resisting. This is because wax is resistant to water. Okay, wax is resistant to water. So if you just keep piling the color, then that won't happen. You have to mix in the water with the color. Only then you will be able to see this resist effect. Just see, as soon as I added water, how all of the water is running away from the wax and the wax surface is clearly visible. Just keep changing the colors and just keep adding one color after another. Okay, use water to mix up the colors. Doesn't matter if you cannot blend it. Doesn't matter. See, it's not blended at all. It's just randomly being added to the paper. Just continue this for the entire paper, entire sheet where you're painting. Remember to use water. Don't just use the raw paint, okay? Because then it won't work. The fact is, the wax that you've used in your wax crayons, that is resistant to water, not the paint. So you need to use water. Okay, don't just apply the paint. Yes. See what a nice and beautiful pattern we have of leaves here. We'll just complete the corners also. I'm now switching it up and I'll be using some green for the corners. Fill up all the sides of the paper like this. Okay. So see what a beautiful, nice and beautiful pattern of leaves you've got. So once it dries up, you will see how nice it looks, as if someone has played with colors on your paper and there is some secret pattern that's evolving out of it. Nicely cover up the corners of your paper. Okay. Everybody complete it. So where can you use this technique? You can use this very same pattern technique on your book covers. Okay, when you make covers for your projects, you can use it there. Also, what you can do is when you send secret messages to your friend. Okay, when you send secret messages to your friend, what you can do is on a white sheet of paper, you can just use the white crayon and you can write something in secret. Because no one will be able to understand it, right? And then when your friend gets home, she can just put the watercolor on top of it and you'll see that the message will come clear. All right? Or if you want to send birthday wishes to someone, what you can do is you can just write a secret message, happy birthday, on the card and you can send it. And then your friend will just take the watercolor, put it on top of the card and the message will reveal itself. Because you've used white wax crayon, they will not understand it even when they see the paper. Got the idea, everyone? It's fun, isn't it? Yeah, you can try it at home first and then using the same idea, you can do the same with your friends and have fun. So what a nice and fun thing you learned today, right? Everybody just complete it quick. Once the painting is dried out, what you can do is the little droplets that are there on the wax surface, just take a nice clean cloth or even your finger and you can just remove all those droplets. They will be easily removable, but don't tamper with the paper while it's wet. Okay, you might end up ruining or tearing up your paper. Don't do that while it's still wet. After the paper has dried out, just take your finger and just remove the little droplets that are there on the leaf portions. Okay, everybody, so what did we learn in today's class? In today's class, we learned about resist painting. So what is resist painting? Resist painting is a technique in which we use two mediums that do not mix with each other. Okay, here we have used our wax crayons and our watercolors. Yes, we also learned about the color selection. Had you used purple color or dark blue color, it would not have been visible over your watercolors, right? Since you have used your orange color or any other happy colors that I suggested, that is why it is being visible right now. So always remember, when you use the resist painting technique, use the light colors as we had discussed. Okay. Also, you learned about your happy colors, color selection. Okay. Yeah. So I hope everybody had fun making this nice resist painting. And remember to make your submissions on time, because the top 10 submissions will be marked and it's a great achievement. And also what happens is that when you make the submissions for all the classes in the course, then you are eligible for a certificate at the end of the course. Okay. So you would not want to miss out on that. This is a nice creative technique that you learn. You've put in your time and efforts to learn this. So remember to make your submissions. All right. Okay. Also, one more thing, if you noticed, you will see that when I have used the colors here at the right hand side, you will see your red and blue mix up to give purple. Okay. And your green and red at the top, they have mixed up to give a brownish kind of color. And in the left hand side, your blue and green colors have mixed up to give a dark green color. So these are the three shades you will get when you mix up all of these colors. Okay. Right. So lot many number of things that you learned in today's class. I hope everybody has completed their painting and has a masterpiece now, which you can hang up in your homes also. Okay. All right. So anybody who missed out on the submission process earlier, you can now pay a look at it at the end of the class and you can make your submissions accordingly. Okay, everybody. All right. I hope everybody enjoyed the class. We'll see you again in the next class with some new techniques. Okay. Till then, everybody keep creating and remember to make your submissions. All right. Okay, everyone. Bye-bye. Take care.
Hi, everyone. We are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link, and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right